Hey everybody, today is September 15th, and our epistle and our gospel reading today have this common thread of the theme of suffering and also of a mystery that is present within the church. So let's look at these two readings. Our epistle today is from St. Paul's letter to the Colossians, and the gospel reading is according to St. Matthew. Now, St. Paul is alluding to a mystery within the church. He says that there's this mystery of Christ present within us, within the church together. And he also mentions the suffering that he is rejoicing in for our sake. And then we also see in our gospel reading, according to Matthew, that the Lord is reminding his disciples that they're going to suffer, that they're going to be offered up, and they're going to have to give an account for their faith among all these different people in government and in their community. But then he tells them, don't be anxious. Don't be worried about what you're going to say or how you're going to say it, because the Holy Spirit is the one who's speaking through you. Now let's look at exactly what he says. He says that he sends forth his disciples as sheep in the midst of wolves, but he tells them that they're to be as wise as serpents and as innocent as doves. And he says, do not be anxious how you are to speak or what you are to say. For what you are to say will be given to you in that hour, for it is not you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. Now, it's important to note that he's not just saying because they're Christians that whatever they say is the Holy Spirit speaking through them. It's not that they suddenly have this superpower where everything they say is God talking through them. What he's saying is that if they're having this relationship, this intimate connection with Christ, and connected with what St. Paul is saying in the epistle, if we are united to the body of Christ, which is the church, and we are in communion with that body, if we are striving in this relationship with Christ, having put on Christ in our baptism, having received the Holy Spirit through our chrismation, living a life sacramentally connected to him and his body through prayer, getting to know him, then we're going to have that intimate connection with Christ, with God the Father and with the Holy Spirit. And when persecutions come, when maybe for you, persecutions aren't going to come in the same way that he's talking about it coming to the disciples. But there will be a day where you're going to need to be able to speak about your faith. And so often, we as Orthodox Christians in our world today feel a little insecure about that. We're not quite sure we're going to have the right words. We're not sure maybe we have the right education, or we know enough. Maybe we don't feel that we've read scripture enough to be able to understand it, or we don't feel that we understand our Orthodox faith enough to explain the differences with our friends or our family. But the message today is that you are not to be anxious about that. You don't need to worry about whether you're an expert at our faith or whether you know everything. What you need to worry about is today, how is your relationship with Christ? And how can you strengthen that relationship through the life of the Orthodox Church today? Focus on that. It's the little things. Getting to be closer with him in prayer. Getting to learn what the epistle and the gospel reading is today and who the saints are that we're celebrating. And in those little things, you're going to get closer and closer with our Lord, so that when you do have these questions of faith and when you do have these questions that people ask of us, you won't be anxious and you won't have to worry what you're going to say, because the Holy Spirit will be present with you to inspire you, to give you words and strength, to be able to explain your faith in simple ways that aren't competitive or you trying to pit up the Orthodox Church against another faith, but simply you sharing of your joy, your experience, and of the presence of the Holy Spirit who is with you. That's our message today, that there's this mystery of Christ's presence within the church and the Holy Spirit continuing to fill the church, to strengthen his members, to be witnesses to him and our world today. May God give you that strength and the surety of his presence with you today. Amen.